The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Seem in Dallas.
Hi, Tom. I love your show.
Thank you so much.
I've been listening to you since 2001 from my Seattle days when you were on a little station there.
I appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Thank you. Well, listen, thanks for bringing us from Seattle to Dallas, man. Appreciate it.
Yeah, I love all the hosts. I love your show. I'm addicted to it.
It's Hotel California. It's wicked, isn't it, man? Thanks.
All right, Tom. Nice to talk to you.
Have a great one. Have a safe one.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. So begin your relationship. Know what you want. Know what the needs of your body are, what the needs of your mind are, and what fits well with you. There are millions of men and women, and some of them will make a good match for you, and others won't. The two of you need to be like a key in a lock, a match that works. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 77, NASDAQ up 20, S&P's up 6.5, gold contract down $32.20, trading at $1,131 an ounce. Silver off $1.19 at $16.02 an ounce. Platinum down $27 at $8.97 an ounce. Copper flat at $2.59. Light sweet crude flat at $52.01 a barrel. Bonds, the 10-year note down 19 ticks, 122.25. 30-year bond off 7 ticks, 148.08. King dollar up 1,400 ticks, trading at 103.125. The euro is at 104, and the yen is trading at 118. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. We'll know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay, so you spy out here, made a high on Tuesday. We made the high on Tuesday, 228.23 to 228.34. We made that high with 110 million shares. We come down yesterday with 142 million. You're going up today with 80 million. And where we are right now, folks, inside these indices right now is right where the announcement came out yesterday at 2:30. I suspect what you're going to see as we come into the close out here, we had one little downdraft out here in the SPY, as in the indices. We got down to a 225.89. That's weird. No, that was last night. This downdraft right here just took you to 226.34. So that's another 50 cents lower. I expect that's where we can get to as we're coming into the close today. Dow Industrials, what do you have with the Dow Industrials? Dow Industrials did the exact same thing. The Dow is testing out its highs up here. We got to a high yesterday of, 19,966. You got to 19,951 today, bottom line. You're backing down off that high. This looks to me coming into quad, witching tomorrow that you're going to have a down day. Composite, NASDAQ composite, what do we have with the composite? Same type of setup in the composite. Now, when we get to the NDX 100, well, the composite did it too. It's pretty cool what it did. So the composite, the high of the composite also was on Tuesday. That was 54.86. We made 54.85 today, and right now you're at 54.55. Bottom line, back down off it. Dramatically lighter volume as we're going testing that. If we go look at the NDX, and what you're going to see here, this one is about as good a test as you can get. If we take a look at the futures, what you're going to see in the futures is this, is that, excuse me, the high that was generated out here on Tuesday, excuse me, folks, the high that was generated out here on Tuesday was 49.6150. We got to 49.6175 out here this morning. Tested it. Tested it with dramatically lighter volume and then came up for an additional test right at 20 past 1 and then bang, someone sold right into it. Sold into it in spades. Right now we have a high volume swing low intraday at the price point of 49.19. You're at 49.31. I expect that's exactly where that baby wants to go down to as we do come into the close. Yeah, I expect that this bear needs some honey, man. That's what I need out here. Let's go take a look at the gold contract. Gold contract, folks, they sliced and diced out here. You're at 11:31 out here today. We got down to 11:24, and if we go take a look at this and you put this on a continuous contract, you're going to see what could be game, which we got to the 11:23 out here today in this continuous contract. You're going into the strength that was established out here last February. That's 11:15. So bottom line, coming into a Friday, that can be had. If you remember, last January, the expansion up when the whole world was bearish, just as they are right now in the contracts, is that that's when we went from 10:46 up to 13:47. The bond market. So what do we have with bonds? This is what you have with bonds. Bond market out here, the 10-year first. 10-year has done 1.9 million contracts. We are down, we got down to 122.14. You're trading at 122.25. This is just barely inside yesterday's low. This is really not a rejection of lower price just yet. It would have to basically close up into about 123, which is not that far from where we are, but that would, to me, would be a rejection of lower price. Now, the 30-year, different ball game. So the 30-year out here has USH7. The 30-year has rejected lower price. Let's see how it's going to stand with volume out here. So we're swapping contracts out. The bottom line is that the 30-year has rejected lower price. So this... The 30-year got down to 147.04. Right now, you're at one. As soon as it got back inside 147.10, you're inside the range. So these bonds are trying to get off the bottom. Dollar index is trading up 1,400 ticks, 1,452 to be exact, and you got 80,000 contracts. So bottom line is that you get a break top side in the dollar, and we'll see where this baby wants to take us. We'll see if in fact this is an ABC structure on the way up. If we do look at the continuous contract, you know, the volumes, because currencies trade without volume, meaning that there's all different venues where they trade. When you do look at this in a continuous contract, bottom line is that there's not that much in the way from here to a $1.13. You know, that being said, guess what? We go to a $1.13. And the reason being, folks, is that what we had is this. When the dollar was trading at 121 in 2002, you went straight down to 84. And, you know, as you come up, there's not much holding this. You know, where we are right now is that we are at ICE, what was established out here in December of 02. You know, my take is that, bottom line, you're not going to get there, but guess what? Technically, that thing can go. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. Dow right now up 66. NASDAQ up 17. S&P's up 5.5. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 65. You get the Nasdaq up 18. S&Ps are up 5. And as we do each and every Tuesday and Thursday, we have our man, Mr. Andy Hecht. And don't forget, folks, at TFNN, every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, we do live programming 8 o'clock in the morning to 5 in the afternoon. Tuesday, Thursday, 7 o'clock in the morning to 6 in the afternoon. Andy's got a great show on every Tuesday and Thursday, 5 to 6 Eastern Standard Time. You can get the show by just going over to TFNN on your cell phone. Hit TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. You're going to get some great audio, video. Andy's also got a great newsletter, the Technometer Commodity Report. The way you test drive that, you go to TFNN, go to newsletters, go to trading newsletters. You can test drive Technometer Commodity Report 30 days absolutely free. Andy Hecht, what's going on?
Hey, Tom, how are you?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing great. So, we had a great show on Tuesday with Bart Chilton.
I heard it. It was a fabulous show.
If anyone missed it, I'm sorry?
I heard it. It was a fabulous show.
Thank you. Yeah, he's a great guest. And if anyone didn't, they can go to the archives and certainly check it out. Definitely worth listening to the words of wisdom from Commissioner Chilton.
No doubt.
Lots of fun. Lots of fun to have him on. Hopefully we'll have him on again in the near future. Markets, hey, let's start with natural gas today.
Natural gas.
So the EIA, I mean, this thing, I'm going to tell anyone who wants to trade natural gas, I think you should get a helmet. Because so today the EIA comes out. They tell us we have this massive withdrawal from inventories, 147 BCF.
Yep.
And what does the price do? It puts in a bearish key reversal.
Yeah. So, see, that's why you should go trade the Nadex platform, folks, because the bottom line, you can get it both ways there. Well, you get defined risk more than anything.
We look back to what happened in September, late September, early October. We rallied all the way up. People got real bullish. It was too early. And then the longs, they got, as you would say, Tom, toasted and roasted.
Yeah.
Took the price all the way down on this contract to 270, 220. And then started getting cold. Market started powering forward. Got all the way up to 377.70, highest price since December 2014. And now we're getting some really, I mean, it's still cold. We're getting some really good withdrawals. But, you know, price action, getting a little, the bulls got a little too overstimulated here. You could see from open interest, We're up at, 1.25 plus million contracts of open interest. We haven't been this high since 2014.
Okay.
So, it's just most people who trade natural gas lose money in it, because what they do is they hop on board too late. They get short at the bottom, they get long at the top. It's a very tough guy. And that's why I said, you got to get a helmet if you want to trade this thing.
Yeah. And it's $10,000 a point, folks. Okay.
Yeah, which is a trip. It is expensive. Yeah, when you're wrong in that one, it's expensive. Crude oil, kind of like the action there today. We took another look down below 50. We bounced back up to 51. Lots of interesting things going on in crude oil. Certainly the politics of it, we don't have to go into that, but there's so much politics, since the OPEC cut, purchase of 19.5% of the major Russian oil company by Glencore and by the Qataris, the appointment of the nomination, rather, of the head of ExxonMobil as Secretary of State. A lot of stuff going on politically in the oil patch. But oil itself, we're seeing the contango increase to about a dollar on the roll from January to February. But in the further dates, we're seeing it contract big time as shale producers do some hedging, which is depressing the forwards and causing backwardation to pop up some places along the forward curve, which is not necessarily a bad thing for the price of oil. The oil price is now absorbing a lot of forward sale of production. The crack spreads are doing nicely. You have the January heating oil gasoline crack spread butting up against $14. The February one is 13.5. That's during off season. That's a good sign. You have the heating oil crack spreads in January at 18.20, and in February they are at 17.89. So that's also kind of moving along, and that's a signal of demand for oil products. So you also have the Brent spread up at about $2, a little bit over $2 premium for Brent, and that's the political premium for oil, but it's also reflective of production cuts coming down the pike in 2017. So if you sum it all up, the market structure in oil is looking good. And I think that, when you get these bouts of price weakness, it's not a bad idea to pick up a couple of barrels here, because I think oil's going to make its way to 60.
No, I hear you loud and clear. I guess where the disconnect for me comes in, that, we had oil pop up to the $55 on Saturday night, right? You're back inside the lower range, and you get your king dollar going to the moon. And oil's priced in dollars.
Absolutely. But we have to remember, oil is double the price it was on February 11th. It's half the price it was in June 2014. And the dollar is an important factor for oil, but it's one of so many factors.
But it's the cost of it.
You got the politics. You got the – well, it's the cost of it, but it's only one of many, many factors.
Okay.
And when I look at oil and I analyze oil, I want to understand the processing spreads. I want to understand the location spreads. I want to understand the term structure. And that gives me a much clearer picture of the actual supply and demand fundamentals for the commodity. So it looks okay to me here, despite the strong dollar. I think if the dollar were to come down, oil could go to $60 very quickly. But the dollar right now, we'll put a chart up there.
So what do you, let's go to silver next.
Let's go to silver. I'd love to go to silver.
I know.
Well, silver basically, when it failed at 1730, it felt to me like it was standing on the end of a cliff, and a gust of 1 mile an hour could push it over. And that's what we had today. We had the Fed come out, raise interest rates 25 basis points, add another rate hike potential to next year, and it basically pushed silver, from 17 to 16. We got down to 15.92.50. We're sitting kind of close to the lows.
Yeah, silver's down 6.5% right now, folks.
Yeah, silver's an ugly day. And Tom, I haven't really liked these precious metals since Election Day. And, I didn't like the action in gold on the monthly chart in November. It was a bearish key reversal. The last time we had that that in the gold market was back in September 2011, and we're following through in gold. And, you know, gold has been edging lower. Silver tried to rally last week, but it was unable to do so, was unable to get above that 1730 level up to the 1733 resistance. It rejected that. And, you know, the end result is, you know, it's watching gold make new lows. Gold is down 6 weeks straight. It's made a new low 6 weeks straight on the weekly chart. And quite frankly, silver, you know, silver capitulated and followed. And you know as well as I do, silver's the kind of commodity. It sits there.
Oh, silver's a psycho. There's no doubt.
It's a psycho, right? It sits there. And all of a sudden, boom, it either, you know, rallies a buck, it dips a buck. But, you know, hey, silver's got to hold $16 or it could get ugly. You know, right now, key support for gold, I see at 1046, which was last December's lows. And gold and silver are really doing very similar to what they did last year, making their lows late in the year.
Yeah, no doubt. You stay right there, folks. Andy and I are coming right back. Dow Industrials right now are up 71. You get the Nasdaq up 19. S&Ps are up 6. Gold's down $32. You get silver off $1.18. And King Dollar's up 1,400 ticks, folks. We're going to be right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC-insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We have the Dow Industrials right now up 59. You get the Nasdaq up 18. S&Ps are up 5. We're talking with our man, Mr. Andy Hecht. We are talking commodities. And, of course, don't forget, Andy's got a great newsletter, the Technometal Commodity Report. You can test drive it 30 days, absolutely free. The way you do it, go over to TFNN, go to newsletters, go to Trading Newsletters. See the Technical Commodity Report right there. Test drive at 30 days, absolutely free.
So as far as the precious, what I remain short. I am, you know, I just lower my stops. That's where I am with those now. You know, it's going to be interesting. I mean, it's very dollar related here. Can the dollar go up and test the 105 resistance? It seems to be that way, but you know, who knows with these crazy markets? Who knows? Now we're in digesting mode from the Fed yesterday. Tomorrow we have a triple witching hour, and then we basically go into holiday mode for the next 2 weeks in the markets, I would assume.
Yeah, no, there's no doubt about that.
Yeah.
I must go ahead.
One market that I'm concerned about here is the copper.
Okay.
You know, copper had a big move, went from 230 to 275. We're kind of sitting around the 260 level here. You know, the strong dollar could weigh on copper, but more importantly, you know, one of the reasons I got really bullish on copper was the drop in LME, London Metal Exchange warehouse stocks, which went from like 350,000 tons down to 230,000 tons. But over recent sessions, the LME has been reporting that stocks are coming back in. So we're back up to close to 280,000 tons, and that could weigh on copper here. So copper could have some downside, and copper could very easily drop to 250 or 240 and still kind of, you know, it, don't forget, it broke out above 230.
Right.
So there is some danger here in the copper market. Another market that I'm looking at that kind of looks good to me here is the cotton. You know, the cotton has just – cotton is also dollar sensitive because U.S. exports and so on and so forth. But cotton is so cheap, you know, at 71 cents a pound or 72 cents a pound. And the chart pattern is really nice to me. It looks really nice to me for the last couple of months. It's been making higher lows. It's been consolidating, and cotton's kind of like silver. When it decides to move, all of a sudden it just, you know, it just
right.
moves. And you got support at 70 cents, then at 66 cents, and you have resistance at 72 and three quarters, and then at 78 cents. And I wouldn't be surprised to see cotton move up and trade at the 80 cent level here. That's kind of my target in terms of long positions here. But lots of volatility, Tom, no question about it. I don't think that's going to end anytime soon. We have a lot of events in 2017 that are going to be interesting. Oh, someone's asking about coffee. Let's take a quick look at that. I think that coffee, you know, I'd like to see it hold $1.35 a pound. I think that's an important technical level. I think that we're going to have to wait till January or February. Traditionally, when coffee starts to move, it's that time of the year when the Brazilian harvest becomes more clear. But it is an off year in the Brazilian harvest here. Of course, you know, with the dollar strong, the real is lower. The price of coffee in real is higher, but I don't think they have tremendous stocks. And I think the shortage of Robusta beans is spilled over to Arabica, and we should stay around $1.35 to $1.45 a pound. But I expect the move to come maybe January, February, March in the coffee market. But what I was going to say is that 2017 is going to be an interesting year, especially for the dollar, because you have three big elections coming up in Europe. You have the election for the Chancellor of Germany, the head of France, and the head of the Netherlands. And it's really, you know, we had that referendum on the EU in Britain. We know what happened there. We had the recent vote in Italy. We know what happened there. It's going to be very interesting to see what happens in the major northern European countries at election time. And it's really the fate of the European Union. The fate of the Union hangs in the balance, I think, in 2017. And it's going to have extreme ramifications on the euro. And very important on the dollar.
And in that case, on the dollar, I see what you're saying. Right.
So, you know, like we had a lot of action in 2016. It was a year of volatility. I don't think that's changing anytime soon, Tom.
Yeah, but we went one way in the market. We went up. That's all
yes.
we did.
Yeah.
Which we didn't think we would do.
Yeah. Well, the stocks, you know, stocks are juiced, man. And you know what? Even, you know, gold's reacting to the Fed interest rate hike. We're seeing some reaction from other commodities. We're certainly seeing a reaction from the dollar. Stocks, man, There just seems like there's a lack of selling in that market, in those markets.
Yeah, no doubt.
So, interest rate. What do you think about the interest? You think they'll, you know, it's intriguing. So, in 2015, they said they're going to go up three times. 2016, three times. Both times they did it once.
Right.
Same language here. The difference in the language here, folks, was that they still said three times. The difference is that it was definitely, they took out the dovishness of it. And, in fact, she was staying away from the deal about making any suggestions that she, at one point there, they were asking her about the fiscal stimulus, and she wanted to make sure that she wasn't going to get in Trump's way, okay?
Right.
But it's definitely, it seemed that the statement was a change, even though they said they were going up three times the last 2 years.
It was a change, and I will tell you, I think that they will push, you know, a big stimulus package, a big infrastructure package through Congress. I think it will cause GDP to go higher, and I think we'll get more than three rate hikes next year. That's my personal view.
So you don't think Trump will go out of his mind with three rate hikes?
I don't think so.
I think
it's the price to pay. I think he's going to love a strong dollar. Listen, Donald Trump, President-elect Donald Trump, is a guy who loves to watch the polls, right? I mean, you'd agree with that. He loves the polls. He loves the ratings on TV, right? So what does he have now? What is his ultimate poll now? The dollar. If the dollar gets stronger, it's a reflection. He'll look at it as a reflection on his success.
Yeah. So if the interest rates go up, it's kind of a reflection on the amount of debt that he has out there on his business, and he's going to get.
Well, it's going to be also a reflection on a growing GDP. It will be a reflection. Now, we will see what the debt picture looks like if he's able to repatriate a lot of these funds from overseas, which will come, you know, with a tax penalty, but it will be a much lower tax penalty than it would be right now. So, you know, look, there's a lot of politics and policy to shake out, but if we do see GDP grow higher than the Fed's expectations, which I don't think is out of the question in 2017, their backs will be against the wall. They'll be forced to hike rates. So, you know, we'll have to see. But there's so many other things. Again, that's one factor. You know, if Europe starts falling apart, you know, there could be some contagion going on. So it's going to be a very interesting year. It's going to be a very volatile year. But, you know, we know our political course based on the election. Of course, the election results have to be finalized next Monday when the Electoral College meets. But after that, we know our political course with a Republican president, Republican control of both houses of Congress. Europe's future will be determined in 2017. Because when it comes to Europe, Tom, Germany and France, hey, they're the 800-pound gorillas.
Wild one. Listen, folks, right here, our man, Mr. Andy Hicks, going to be coming up 5 to 6 Eastern Standard Time tonight. And check it out right on your cell phone. Go to TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. Andy, have a great one. Have a safe one. Look forward to the show at 5 o'clock.
Thanks so much, Tom.
Thank you. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now are up 56. The Nasdaq's up 20. S&P's are up 5.5. We're going to be right back, folks.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These four-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. So let's go take a look at the strength versus the weakness inside the Dow Industrials. Strength out here, folks, today is Goldman Sachs. That's up 1.5% or 376. You get DuPont up 1.5% or $1.14. J.P. Morgan Chase up 1.4%, 124. American Express up 1.3 at 99. Taken away from it, you have Nike down 1.2. You have GE down 1. United Technologies off 9 tenths. And Boeing is down 5 tenths. If we go over and we take a look, because three out of those four top are inside the XLF. If we go over to the XLF, the financials, what you're going to see out here is the XLF is up 24 cents. Your high out there yesterday was 23.83. We hit 23.87. Bottom line is that testing that high with 97 million versus 142. So coming into option expiration tomorrow is going to be wild. No two ways about that. You can expect higher volatility. I expect two-way markets out here. Inside the NDX 100, what do we have? Strength versus the weakness. Strength out here is Xilinx. That's up 6% or $3.46. You get Illumina up 5.3%. Mondelez is up 4.4%. Alexion Pharmaceutical is up 2.3%. Taken away from it, Yahoo is down 5.5% or $2.39. You got JD.com down 4.4%. Baidu is off 2%, and you get Express Scripts down 1.8. If we go back to Yahoo for a second, this is all about the 1 billion. Talk about getting identities and, well, at least accounts basically broken into. Pretty amazing when you take a look at the aspect of Yahoo. Yahoo, 1 billion accounts, bottom line, it's taken out a B point of an ABC structure on the way down, and you have that high volume swing low that's laying out here from June 27th to $35. And if we take a look at this, so you got A of 44, yeah, you get approximately $6. So that 34, $35 is game. You know, you're breaking the B point out here, and you are breaking that B point with volume. No two ways about that. Inside the indices out here, what we have, let's go take a look at these indices. Volume out in the indices, that's going to be short volume. So we're at 673 million right now. That'll run into about 850. Yeah, you can do about 850, 900 million in the NYSE. We take a look at the composite. The composite's going to have volume. So this is going to be interesting in the composite. The composite's 1.7 billion right now. And we'll pull this up again. Well, it's going to be interesting. So with the composite, actually, so the last 3 days, let's see what we've done, because the composite looks like it's going to have volume. So you're testing the highs of yesterday and the day before. Yesterday we did 1.97. The day before we did 2. So we'll see where that shakes out as we do come into the close. The small caps, the IWM, we take a look at the IWM out here. What we have with the IWM, this is up a buck right now. You're at 36.14. The high of yesterday was 137.35. We got to the 137.14, and right now it couldn't handle that price. We'll see how this closes out. We definitely can get volume in this, because what we did have is this. Yesterday you came down with the 45 million. Now we're going up with 37. But what does happen inside the IWM is that there's a huge amount of volume that comes in at the close on IWM. That's how that thing shakes out. If we go take a look at some of the higher volume stocks in this market, you have Bank of America is up 51, GE is down 29, you have Pier 1 up $2. That was a huge move by Pier 1. That's an earnings deal, Gap Tire. Hecla Mining is down 47 cents. You get Marbell up 50 cents. Mondelez, that's a rumor it's going to be a takeover. NVIDIA, NVDA, I believe this is breaking all-time highs. Yeah, so NVIDIA, this had Gap Tire on the 9th and 10th. I think that was earnings versus the election. Bottom line is that this thing is on fire, man. Yeah, this is a one-way shot. There's no two ways about that. We go take a look at the XAU and the HUI. This is what you have inside the XAU. XAU is down to $3.43. Now, I won't get the volumes inside the XAU or the HUI until tonight to see what kind of volume has taken out these swing lows. So the swing low we're taking out in the XAU is $75.54. If we do bring this back, what you're going to see, though, is this, is that you're actually coming into where the strength was established all through the run higher from January until July. And what you're going into on a weekly basis, it's going to be really hard to break this thing down. The reason being is that you're coming at the 373 million in the XAU. If you want to see the correlation, if we just do to the GLD for a second, you're going to see the GLD has done a good test out here today. So it's going to be interesting watching how this shakes out tomorrow. And this is what it is. So the GLD, thus far, we've done about 36 million, I think. So we've done 38 million. So figure it's going to be about 48 million that we're going to do. The 48 million is coming into, it's $107.35. That's where this baby, you know, not just went topside, okay? When this went up in from January to July, it was a one-way trip topside. You're coming into that strength. That strength was 107.35. We did 60 million shares, and looks like we're going to do about 40. We could do about 48 million. If we did what we did today, I can add, right now I've done 38. You can add another 10 million at least. So let's add 12 million. The bottom line, you know, we'll see where this shakes out tomorrow. So, and what you need, of course, is that you need a rejection of lower price. We'll see how that shakes out. And if that would be the case, that means that the good old King Dollar's got to do something other than continue its path higher. What is going to be pretty cool out here today is that after the close, what you are going to have is Oracle's going to be coming out with their numbers, folks. And the CEO of Oracle, this was a heads up, a big time too. Before they were meeting with Trump yesterday, she was talking about that 60% of their sales are overseas. So we're going to find out real quick. Let me make sure 60%. I think that's what the number was. Because what's going to happen, they're coming out with their numbers after the close today. And so this is even before the higher dollar move. And the way Oracle is trading right now, it came into Oracle right now. So Oracle's into its downdraft from June of last year. It came down last year from 45 to 40, did 178 million shares. Did countertrend bounce, go back up to that level, and did 137 million. Couldn't handle it. come back up to the level again, did 56 million. Come up to that level last week with 63 million. So you get 63 versus the 137 versus the 178. That's saying that Oracle is going to have a tough time getting to higher price out here today. Oracle sales, let me just, I got to get this again. Okay. Come on. I'll get that story. I just want to make sure it's a 60%. It's a huge amount of sales. That's the bottom line that Oracle does overseas. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now up 64. Nasdaq's up 21. S&P's are up 5.5. We're going to be right back, folks.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go to Keener in Dallas, Texas. Hey, Keener, what's going on, brother?
How you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. Appreciate it.
Thank you for taking my call.
Absolutely.
I was listening to you and Andy talk, and for some reason I checked my list of little shipping stocks that I have, and I noticed that 6 out of the 8 that I have on my list took huge moves today. And I was wondering, since you've been in the market so long, DCIX, Dierra Dry Ships, EC, GLBS, SINO, they all went up like crazy. And I was curious if you had any insight, because I don't understand what I'm looking at.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
I don't understand it. They all jumped.
The bottom line, folks, is that these have been cycles. Okay, so if we look at Diane Shipping first, what you're going to see is that you go back to November 9th, It was $2.44. Stock is up to $4.97, pulls all the way back down to $2.80, and taken off again. You know, I mean, yeah, this can go to $3.98. There's no doubt. Dry ships. Do not touch dry ships, folks. So dry ships is a different animal. What happens with dry ships is this. There's only 1 million shares outstanding right now. To be exact, there's 1.1 million shares. Actually, no, there's only 842,000 that are floating right now. Out of that, there's 292,000 that are shot. Okay, so there's no shares. And, you know, dry ships, folks, is an equity that went from $4.75 up to $102 in 5 days and then crashed and then went back to $4. You know?
Well, it occurred to me, and it's probably not legitimate in terms of an explanation, but it seemed that there might be a relationship between the move in the dollar or the increase in interest rates or something like that.
I hear you, but it wouldn't be a move in the dollar. The dollar stronger is not good for commodities. That's the bottom line. Commodities, and Andy disagrees with me this, but, you know, he's a bear in the metals, but all commodities are priced in dollars, okay? Dollar keeps going, every commodity will get killed. We'll be rich beyond belief and we'll be able to buy everything for nothing. You know, that's just how it goes. So these shippers are moving commodities, okay? So that wouldn't be it. I guess I could base it on is that guess what? If everything starts moving, yeah, you know, that the ship is like moving like this though. That's the real bottom line. What ends up happening is that they sit there, then they move, you know.
I wish I'd seen them this morning, but I'm not sure I would have even believed it.
Yeah, no, you can. Well, DSA, the one not to believe is Dry's, okay? DSX is a nice stock to trade.
Do you know anything about Sino, S-I-N-O?
S-I-N-O. I think this is the... Let's see. So this is the company handles roll-on, roll-off, very large crude carrier. Okay, so this is a crude carrier. Let me just see something. What do we got here? No, I wouldn't touch this thing. This thing takes in 1.8 million. That's it. Yeah, this is a gaffe. Yeah, I wouldn't trade that.
So looking at this list of 6 out of 8 that jumped today, I should basically just call it an aberration or maybe a learning experience. I don't know, I'm trying to figure out whether this thing
No, they go like that, but that what they are, okay, a few of these, okay, well, probably 6 out of the 8 of them, as you're saying, what those are is that there's not a lot of shares out there. So as soon as they start moving, everyone jumps on them because they're cheap stocks, okay? So they're day trading stocks, but guess what? If you don't get out of them, you're toast, man. Do you know what I mean?
So we're looking for toast tomorrow, huh?
No. They can run a couple days, man. Cooking, brother.
All right, well, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
You stay there. You stay there, folks. We're going to come right back with numbers. You got Adobe coming out, Oracle coming out, Jabil coming out. Dow Industrials up 62, Nasdaq's up 20, S&Ps are up 5.5. We're going to be right back.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.
following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Mike in Wilmington. Hey, Mike, what's going on?
Hey, Tommy. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Good, pal. Good. I'm calling to give you a compliment because I just want your listeners to know that you are on your game right now. I've been listening to you for a lot of years, Tom, and you are on your game. And I'll tell you, I'll never forget you calling King Dollar back when it was in the 70s. You saying it was going here, and everybody couldn't even believe that it could even dream that it was ever going to go back to the 90s.
I appreciate the feedback, man.
All right, pal.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. You are only responsible for your half of the relationship. There are two halves in every relationship, but you're only responsible for your half of that relationship. It is not up to you to control the other half, respect the other half, and there's always going to be peace in that relationship. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 59, NASDAQ up 20, S&P's up 7.5, gold contract down $33, trading at $11.30 an ounce, silver down $1.17 at $16.05 an ounce, platinum off $27.897 an ounce, copper flat at $2.59 an ounce, an ounce, that'd be a trip. Oil's flat at $52.14 a barrel. Notes, 10-year note, down 21 ticks, 122.33. 30-year bond, off 10 ticks, 148.05. King dollar, up 1,400 ticks at 103.130. The euro is trading at 104, and the yen is at 118.14. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? We have Fed Day yesterday. You'll get option expiration tomorrow. This is how it's shaking out, folks. What you had in the SPY, we hit a high on Tuesday. That high was $228.34. You did that with 110 million shares. We come down yesterday with 142 million. You're going up today with 117. Bottom line, it looks to me like what that's going to be setting up is that we're going to try to get into the lows that were established out here yesterday. That's on your S&Ps. We go into the Dow Industrials, and we come into quad witching tomorrow, folks. Okay, so buckle up big time. What you have inside the Dow Industrials is the same type of setup. You know, you have three separate highs up here. The first high was established on Tuesday, which was 19,953. You had 19,966, which was the high of yesterday. You come up, you try to test that baby out here today, and the volume wasn't bad. It was 900, and we probably did a billion. Let me see. It was 997 million. Yeah, we did a billion. So the billion's testing a billion. The composite did the exact same thing, meaning testing these highs out. The NASDAQ composite, the high is Tuesday, 54.86. We got to 54.85.12 today. That test was on 2 billion, so it's actually 2 billion going against 2. It's 2.066 going against 2.083. The NDX 100, if we look at the three Qs, what you're going to have with the three Qs is this. Three Qs out here. Now, this is pretty cool. This one here, this is a test on dramatically lighter volume. So this is how this is shaking out. Tuesday, we got to a price point of $121.11. We did that with 54 million shares, while the test today was with 22 million. So that sets up a failure on price, failure on volume. That also, the next move would set up that because we broke out on Tuesday, the next move you'd be looking for is a close under $119.66. Now, bottom line, if we get that tomorrow, that'll be a failure on price, on volume, on the daily, and on the weekly charts. King gold contract. What do we have with gold? Gold, they toasted, roasted, all of the above, with the dollar going higher. Gold went down $33 today. Well, I went down further than that. We hit 1124. Trading at 1130 right now. If we do go and look at the continuous contract, what you're going to see is this. Gold is coming into the strength that it had from last February. If you remember, last February, the gold market, folks, we went from 1046 in December up to 1376, straight line move. You're coming right into the strength. So we're coming into a Friday, which is always dangerous in the gold market, period. Bottom line, this thing can go hit 1115. 1115 is where we took off from in February of 20. We went from that week, we went from 1115 to 1174. If you look at the GLD, we're getting this test, and you're getting this test on dramatically lighter volume. So if we go pull up the GLD and you see how this is shaking out, the GLD today came down $1.49. We are trading right now at 107.34, and you're coming into 60 million shares. And thus far, we have done 41 million. We did 14 million today. So it really depends on how much we do tomorrow. Tomorrow is going to be a big number as to how much we can do. If you close over the 107.35, right now 107.34, with lighter than 60 million, that's going to be a test on lighter volume, and we'll see whether it rejects that lower price. Bonds, we take a look at the 10-year first. 10-year continued to try to basically reject lower price, but it didn't do it. 10-year closed at 122.22, and that would have had to close above 122.30. Big volume, we did 2 million contracts. The 10-year right now is at a high for the year. We're 2.6 in the 10-year. We take a look at the 30-year, what you have with the 30-year. 30-year is trading at 148.05. Now, here's where the difference comes in. The 30-year did reject lower price. The 30-year today got down to a price point of 147.04, and it came up point up from that. At the last high that was established out here was 147.10, which was on Monday. So we'll see whether the 30-year can get any juice tomorrow and make it to higher price. King dollar, we take a look at King dollar. What you have with King dollar is this. King dollar goes topside. King dollar is up 1,392 ticks right now. You're at 103.120. Bottom line, it's going to be pretty wild watching this thing shake out, because what you do have with King dollar is that the way that it came down from 2002 to 2004, it was a straight line move down, and guess what? You're in that whole area right now. We are coming into ice, but you know, realistically, this thing could go up just as quick. I'm not in the camp that that's where it's going, but technically, that's how it's set up. The reason I'm not in that camp is that the stretch in King Dollar, when you take a look at how the equities are trading, bottom line, one of them's wrong. Either the equity market's going to fall apart because the earnings are overseas. You know, we'll find out real quick. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We get our man, Mr. Chris Gaffney, coming back, the president of Everbank World Markets. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 59, NASDAQ up 20, S&P's up 6.5. And of course, we have our man, Mr. Chris Gaffney, the president of Everbank World Markets, who we always have on as soon as these we get these Fed announcements. And as you come over to TFNN, folks, you're going to see the Everbank banner on the top and on the side. You can hit that banner. When you hit it, you're going to see what comes up. It's grab your passport and step into foreign currencies. What this is all about is that adding foreign currencies to your financial portfolio can be tricky, no doubt. Everbank has an account. It's a world currency access deposit account. And guess what? You can start this with as little as $100 a month, and you can trade. Well, you don't have to trade. You can choose from 19 different foreign currencies. And since we have King Dollar going to the moon and the world thinks it's going to continue to go to the moon, bottom line, you're going to Europe, you're going to South America, you have children that are going into college over in Europe. This is a great time to basically hedge your bets. Chris Gaffney, welcome back to TFNN.
Thank you very much. And vacations are on discount.
They're on discount. I'm telling you, you know, it's hard to believe, Chris, but the bottom line is that, you know, when you look at the dollar, you know, people are saying, okay, we can get to 120 again. You know, it's like, okay, we're really going to own the world. And hey, maybe we do. But guess what, folks?
Yeah.
You know, you can hedge this out. It's not even hedging it out. What I love about these accounts, Chris, is that if you have a trip to, let's say you want to go to Europe, you want to go to Italy, or this is a beautiful place, man. Well, guess what? You know, you can do it. And this is a great way to save money, to get to that trip.
Yeah, and I think the key is, of course, is diversification, and that's what we built these accounts for, is for people to get diversification into the foreign currencies. And what better way than dollar cost averaging? And that's so we introduced just this year the ability for people to buy as little as $100 once or twice a month.
Okay.
It's automatically done. So you sign up for the program, and Tom, you know how emotional investing can be. You can, and typically your emotions work against you. When something runs up in price, you don't want to buy it. You know, it's too expensive, and you want to wait for it to come back down. Or when it falls, you really don't want to sell. A lot of people want to double down, or you know, emotions get in. Well, what dollar cost averaging does is it takes emotions out of that decision, and you invest a set amount on a regular basis. And in my opinion, it's the best way to establish a position in currencies or commodities or whatever you're doing. And take that timing out of the market, you know, take the emotion out, take the timing out. Yeah, it's cheap today. I mean, the dollar's ran up. So if you're buying currency, it's cheaper today than it was yesterday. But who knows if it's going to be cheaper tomorrow. So,
no, there's no doubt. Now, let me ask you, I figure you can. Like, on each account, right, let's say that someone wants to go to Italy, okay? They can open one basically with, a euro, right? Then let's say that they want to go down to South America and they're going to open one, let's say going to Colombia with a peso. Do you open two separate accounts, Chris? How does that work?
Yeah, each currency would be held in a separate currency account. So
okay.
We have about 21 different currencies. Unfortunately, the peso is not one of them. Brazil is.
Can
go to Brazil.
Brazil, that works.
But,
okay.
Colombia, yeah, we haven't added that yet. But each currency would be a separate account. Each would be a separate program. So you would need to, if you wanted multiple currencies, you could do that.
Sure.
Now, you could also switch if your plans change and you wanted to move your euros into Australia, we could do that. We can convert it and switch them from euros right to Australian dollars. And again, the main reason for this, while, it's neat to talk about travel and that's something everybody can relate to.
Yes.
I think the main thing is that diversification. It's a non-correlated asset class.
Right.
Currencies are not related to other classes. And so it's smart to add a position to foreign currencies to your portfolio. That's what we mainly like.
So the Mexican peso, we have the Mexican peso, yes?
You bet.
And so that's a huge one, too. I mean, it's so close to us, number one, but there's plenty of people that, in fact, I know some Tigers, they were talking to us, they actually called, and they were saying that the king dollar is king down there, but they felt, and they're originally from Mexico and live in the United States right now, and they went down and bought a house. So that's a great way to basically diversify simultaneously.
Sure.
I was convinced yesterday that it was a great deal, and it just as you said, well, now it's a better deal.
Exactly, in Mexico especially, and we've done that. We've financed those. We've had people come buy foreign currency that are moving or buying a major purchase. We financed a gentleman was buying gliders from Germany, and so he bought euros from us to do that. So we've done a lot of those type of transactions, and again, with the dollar up where it is, what a great time to start. If you don't already own currencies, what a fantastic time to get started, because you're buying when prices are relatively cheap compared to where they've been.
Sure. And it seems that if we go back, folks, and whether it's 5, 10, 15, 20 years, you never could do something like this. Because I'm in the commodity market so much, I understand currencies a lot better now than I did in the past. But it's so cool understanding, every time that I hear people, turn around and say, okay, the dollar will continue to go up and our markets continue to go up. Well, I'm a technical trader, but I know fundamentally that can't happen. Because guess what? All the earnings, are so much from overseas. It's like, okay, that's going to hurt at one point.
Well, investors look forward and they're looking past. So, while we thought a lot of this rate increase was baked into the dollar,
yes.
I still believe it was. What wasn't baked in was the next three rate increases. And so now, all of a sudden, investors have baked in those next three. Well, you remember last year at this time, a similar occurrence happened where everybody thought we were going to get four rate increases
yes.
in it this year. And then as soon as they started backing away from that, the dollar sank. So, we could see the same thing. We could, go ahead and see three rate increases. We could see four. If we see four, you could see a little more dollar strength. But the key is on a longer term basis, we haven't seen the dollar index at these levels since 2002.
Right.
So, it's been a long time since we've seen these levels on the dollar. And while, it certainly could get stronger, I think it's a good time and to get started if you haven't already started, or to increase your positions in foreign currency. You're in my opinion, you're not going to get burned in the long run making those investments at this time.
No, and you know what's so cool? Folks, we're not talking about a trade. You're talking about a real financial plan. And guess what? You're planning it yourself. And EverBank makes it happen, okay, because they have these. So you're not paying the fees for a financial advisor. You are the advisor. Bottom line, you spread it out. You're the advisor. How cool is that, right?
Right. And another thing, these currency accounts are IRA eligible. I know
huge.
That
yep.
most of investors, you know, that's where their investment, that's where their portfolio,
yes.
their main investment portfolio lies is within that tax deferred account. So, yes, IRAs, you can do this in an IRA, and it's a great place because those are longer term investments.
No doubt. Folks, their phone number is 855-750-4051. Just go to everbank.com/TFNN. Chris, have a great one, safe one. Thank you so much. Look forward to having you on again.
Happy holidays. We'll see you.
Have a great one. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go to Mike in Colorado. Hey, Mike, what's going on?
Hey, Tom. I wanted to ask you about Franco Nevada. It didn't really get whacked as hard today, and it rallied for most of the day off of its lows. What do you think?
Let's take a look. So you get Franco Nevada. Franco Nevada, the low for the year, folks, is 41. The high is 81. This is a one of the premier royalty stocks out here. And what Mike's talking about is that you had the swing low out here of $53.87 that was established on the 14th of November. You went to 53.31 with 1.3 million versus 2.4 and rejected it. Yeah, I can see what you're looking at. if we bring this back, let's see how what it's going into. So it's also, so watch this on the weekly. On the weekly, folks, this is going to get intriguing. Pretty, really intriguing too, actually. So the gold market right now, the GLD is going into the week of February 12th. That was a huge week when we went up from January till July. Franco-Nevada is coming into this exact same price point. The high of the week of February 12th is $54.83. We did 15 million shares. Well, Franco-Nevada is going to do all of like maybe 6 million shares. The 6 million is going up to 7.5, which is the swing point that you had, we both brought up, which was in November. And then you're coming into this, the February one. I like the deal. That's the bottom line. I mean, I think if you don't own it, you can wait to see in the morning what they're going to try to do with gold. Because Friday and there's no doubt Friday with a bad week in the metals market, I suspect we're going to get some kind of a spike down. You know, but it doesn't, you know, they've already basically taken it apart. But I like how it's
Merry
set
Christmas.
Up.
Yeah. Merry Christmas, Tom.
Merry Christmas to you. Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Oracle. Let's go take a look at a couple of numbers that just come out. Oracle just come out with numbers. Oracle closed at $40.86. That's trading at $40.10 right now. Numbers go like this. The estimate was 60 cents. They made 61. And here you go. If you think this is going to be wild watching this shake out. Oracle Corporation posted second quarter sales that missed some analyst estimates, hindered by the stronger U.S. dollar as it shifts focus to selling more cloud-based software and services. Revenue in the period ended November 30th. Now, this is before the dollar even took off, folks. Revenue in the period ended November 30th was a little changed from the year earlier at $9 billion. Analysts had estimated $9.12 billion. Oracle, which gets half of its sales outside of the U.S., was slammed in the quarter by a surging dollar, which rose by more than 5% against the group of key currencies. And in picture this is the last quarter. This is not this quarter. That overshadowed the company's advances in cloud-based products or software the customers access via the internet instead of installed applications on their own servers. Sales from Oracle's cloud business gained 62% in the recent period compared with the 59% jump in the quarter. A lot of currencies depreciated significantly against the quarter, during the quarter. Yeah. So what happens, folks, is that when the stronger the... So Oracle, I believe the CEO said yesterday that it was 60% of their sales were outside of the country. So what ends up happening is that the stronger the dollar gets, the more that they're going to have a hard time, or any company is going to have a hard time bringing profits to the bottom line. Because what ends up happening, the currency conversion takes companies south so quick, it's amazing, okay? That's just how it shakes out. Adobe, A-D-B-E, let's see what Adobe has to say. Adobe closed at $105.50. That's trading at $105.50. Numbers go like this on Adobe. Let's see, their estimate was 86 cents, they made 90 cents. That's the bottom line estimate. Top line estimate, $1.59 billion. They took in $1.61 billion. So bottom line, they beat both sides of it. Bottom line is that it's not doing much to the stock after the earnings. Adobe Systems forecast revenue that disappointed investors, hampered by greater competition for marketing software. That's part of the company's shift to the cloud. Revenue is projected to be about $1.625 billion in the first quarter. That compares with analyst estimates of $1.65 billion. So before we even start talking the dollar, their earnings, their gross numbers are coming down. Chief executive, let's see. Fourth quarter revenue climbed 23% to $1.61 billion, the company said in a statement. Analysts estimated $1.59 billion. So that was over. Fourth quarter net revenue was $399 million. That was up from $222 million a year earlier. These companies know how to grow, though. I tell you, man, when you can grow like that, it's pretty amazing. Let's see. Okay, JBL. Jabil, I believe, was coming out with numbers, too. Jabil closed at $21.57. Jabil is trading at $23.41. Now, Jabil is one of the largest manufacturers for all these other companies that we talk about all the time. Okay, so let's see what they have to say. Jabil, their net revenue was $5.1 billion. The estimate was 64 cents. They made 69 cents. Okay, so let's see. First quarter for they're in the first quarter of 2017. Operating income was $165 million. Core operating income was $209 million. The CEO's quote is, "I'm really pleased with our strong first quarter results. In particular, we saw strength in healthcare, packaging, consumer lifestyle business within our DMS segment," not sure what that means, "combined with yet another solid quarter of execution, allowing us to deliver excellent results." Their net revenue, okay, so for second quarter, this is where the guidance comes in. Second quarter, they're looking for $4.2 billion to $4.5 billion. The operating income, they're looking, wow, this is, what a spread this is. This is pretty amazing, actually, is that they really don't know what their operating income is going to be. They're looking for $39 million to $101 million. That is one spread. That's pretty amazing. Their core operating income, $125 million to $165 million. Yeah, they don't give them, you talk about giving guidance. This guidance is so weird, it's amazing. So their earnings per share, they're saying it's 35 cents to 57. You know, bottom line is that that seems to be that they're not quite sure where this whole thing's going to go. That's how it seems to read out right there. But bottom line is they're making money. That's the other side of it. If we go take a look at, oh, look at this one, the GILD. Let's go see what Gilead is doing after hours. So Gilead Sciences, rather, closed at $75.55. That's trading down a buck right now, which is not the end of the world. This is an equity, though, that has been going down for quite some time. And the high in this equity was $1.23. You're at 75 right now. They just got hit with a bill. That's pretty amazing. So Gilead was told to pay Merck $2.54 billion in hepatitis C royalties. Gilead must pay $2.54 billion to Merck for using a patented invention as the basis for its blockbuster drugs in a potentially deadly liver disease, a federal jury in Wilmington, Delaware, said about 20 minutes ago. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence.
Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Take your phone calls
now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien. Welcome back, folks. We had Big Blue down 49 cents. You had Caterpillar up 79. Coke was up 34. You had DuPont up 118. Let's go to our man Brent in Martinez, California. Hey, Brent, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom. How are you today?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing well, thank you.
Cool.
Thanks for taking the call.
Appreciate the call.
I had this stock I was hoping you could take a look at. It's been in a consolidation for a long period of time. I have owned it in the past. It put in a bottom like I think last year around December or something. But my question more was had to do with the. I was hoping you could take a look at the financials on it. It seemed like a pretty solid company to me. You're better at that than I probably
okay,
am.
Okay, so is it Antero? Is that right?
Yes.
Antero yep. Resources. So the symbol is AR. The low for the year is 19. The high is 30. It's got a big PE. It's got a 38 PE, but let's see what they take in. So they take in plenty of bread. They take in $760 million a quarter. Okay, so let's see. So this is they explore, develop, produce oil and natural gas. The company focuses on acquisition, development, production of unconventional oil and gas, oil and liquids rich natural gas properties. So it's a U.S. company. So it's U.S. based, U.S. all across the line. So if we pull
this. Yeah, I think they're based out of Denver, actually.
Yes, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, I can see this is a long consolidation. I see what you're looking at. Okay, so let me, on a weekly. Okay, so.
Well, that's what I wanted you to look at, because when I look at Yahoo, it shows the PE way less than what you're talking about. So I'm glad I had you look at it, because it's not even close. They're showing the PE being at like 5, and you're showing at 38, so not even close, not even anywhere in the ballpark.
Okay, right. So. I can see what you're looking at here. So far, you got a rejection of lower price here this week. You get down to 24.58. It says no. It's going to have lighter volume. You're going against the strength from January. You know, it's a decent setup, man, because I like, you know, and I'm sure you know that June high volume, you know, we went to $30.50, and you're pushing that swing point from April with volume, you know, so it looks like it wants to go, man. You know, that's kind of how this is set up. Let me put this on a monthly for a second. I see. Interesting. Yeah, no, I like how this is set up. Now watch this, folks. This gets interesting. On a monthly Brent, right? So we hit 30.50. Oh, it didn't take it out. I see. Interesting. Oof. Okay. Just make sure. That's wicked. And so when I first looked at this, folks, so these swing points are crucial. But this, the month of June, you hit 30.50. You did 106 million shares. You're going to 30.66 at 51. It's like, oh, man, why couldn't you just take that out? So just keep a stop in if you're there, you know. It should have taken that out. That's what it should have done, you know. But.
Yeah, I see what you're looking at. I don't own it at all at this point. I wanted your opinion on it. It was kind of interesting. It seems to be kind of whippy to look at on a daily chart. You know, it has some fairly big intraday moves.
It does. This is a psycho stock. You know, you're talking about a stock that moves $2, folks, almost every day, or every 4 or 5 days. Yeah, that's pretty intense, man.
You know, but big candles all over the place.
Yeah, and what you did out here today, you did reject lower price, man. You know,
it did. Yeah, it came down and kind of got down to 24 something, and it didn't stay there long. It kind of backed up.
So we got quad witching tomorrow, man.
yeah.
So you know, quad witching, folks, is that you know you have the futures on the options. They expire on the open, and then, of course, so we get all the indices and the equities and everything else expires at the close. And what Brent loves to do is we'll see whether he gets a shot at it, but the bottom line is that you can put some trades on right at the open, depending on whether you got an expansion up, expansion down, all of the above. So it's going to be an interesting day.
Yeah, those weekly ones can be fun. They can go on some pretty crazy rides. I do have one quick question for you. I've had thoughts that for a while that there's the potential for gold to kind of do what I think Andy mentioned it too, that it could come back down. And you know, the last year I know it hit a low around this time of year. It's more towards the end of the year.
Yeah.
But what are your thoughts on that? I mean, it looks like we could have that reality is fairly substantial that it could do that.
And we'll see how we make it by tomorrow. I mean, that's what it really comes down to. The equities, you know, we're right into this February 5th time frame. And that's where, you know, you had some good strength. On the continuous contract, if you break the 1115, I mean, my take is that 1115, you know, can get tested here. You break 1115, then I'd say that, yeah, you can go to the low. Right now, the way the GLD is set up, the way that the larger gold and silver equities are set up, they, you know, like Barrick Gold today, that rejected lower price. It's done a 50% retracement of the move higher. It's coming into, on a weekly basis, it's coming into 102 million, and you're coming into, you know, 139 million, 140 million. So that's going to be a close call, but, you know, thus far, it's basically only a 50% retracement. Newmont, which has been a dog, you know, actually, this is pretty interesting on the weekly because it's held the price from November. So November, Newmont went down to that $30.19 spot. And this is also, you know, coming into the same time frame. So it's not that there's a disconnect with them, but certainly the way that they went up, when you go up, these equities, folks, went up 300%. So a 50% retracement is not the end of the world, you know.
No, I'm putting a list together myself right now, and I, you know, see how they all.
Well, even when we just had Mike call, Mike was talking about Franco-Nevada. So what happens, folks, is this: Franco-Nevada and Royal Gold are most times two of the best indicators when the actual physical metal wants to move higher. Now, Franco-Nevada is a great-looking equity right now, man. It's pretty sick, actually. Franco-Nevada has come down 50 cents today. It rejected lower price. It rejected the price from November 18th. That's not even the big deal. The big deal is that it's going into the highs of its strength from February of 2016. And you're coming at the 15.8 million. It's like, man, okay, I like that trade. I really like that trade. So let's go look at Royal. And when you take a look at Royal Gold didn't hold price here today. We're at 62.47. It didn't break the low, however, of November 14th also. So when we bring this back, what you're going to see is that Royal Gold, I don't even think, is down a 50% retracement. So when you look at the equities, you know, slice and dice these. Yeah, look at that. So Royal Gold has only done a 0.382 retracement of the move up, you know. So that's still staying strong, you know. It's a 0.382 retracement when you're talking about a move that we had. And if you were in those equities, folks, you know that those equities were as about as intense as you got. You know, Royal Gold went from $24 up to $86.
So, heck of a move.
Until tomorrow morning, brother.
All right.
Okay.
Have a good one, Tom. Thank you.
You too. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
Join Andy Hecht as he shows you how to make money in commodities. The Commodities Hour, next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. And folks, as you come over to our website at TFNN.com, what you're going to see right on the front page is the Salvation Army Tiger Dollar Sale. Now, we do this a few times a year. The Salvation Army, we only do this at the Christmas time. And this is a great way to save quite a bit of money if you have any services at TFNN, if you're looking to get any services at TFNN, as well as getting a tax-deductible donation on your taxes. And the way this works, first off, Tiger Dollar is good for any product at TFNN, no expiration date, and they're totally transferable. The way this works is that you could buy $600, so the cash amount would be $600. We are given a 25% bonus on everything that is bought this time. That's a different twist on it. So if you buy $600, you get $750 Tiger Dollars. What you also get is that we are going to give to the Salvation Army in your name $60. So 10% of the cash value we give. So we're banging on another 35% on top of this. Salvation Army will send to you the tax deductible receipt. We put all the names on a spreadsheet. I think we've done this either 5, 6, 7 years right now. And Salvation Army is number one, a great place to donate, because when you look at the administrative cost, it's almost nil. Everything goes to people that really need something. So that's the $600 one. You can buy $1,200 and you end up getting $1,500 to spend. Then we donate $120 to Salvation Army. Or you can buy $1,800, then you get $2,250, which is an additional $450 bonus. And we donate $180 to the Salvation Army. Now, this started yesterday. It goes until December 22nd. So I believe that's, is that a week? That's a week from today. And it will be closed that day, folks, because we have to not only close it, we have to get the names over to the Salvation Army and the check to the Salvation Army so that they will send to you for the tax year of 2016, bottom line, the tax deductible certificate. So check it out on the front page of TFNN. Great way. If you do have any products right now that you get at TFNN, if you're looking for any in the future, great way to save quite a bit of money. Tomorrow, you get quad witching, and that volatility, that's going to basically not only stay out there, I expect it's going to get even a little more intense. What we will see, what's going to get intriguing here, is that Oracle come out with the numbers. Oracle was complaining about the strong dollar in their numbers, and we're talking about that's last quarter, okay? If we look at the dollar, which is going to be intriguing here, if they were crying about last quarter, guess what? If we get into this quarter, they were crying when the dollar was down at 94, folks, and the dollar is at 103 right now. So they're going to be screaming, as is many of these multinational companies, which, by the way, in Oracle's case, that's 60% of their earnings are overseas. What I actually didn't realize, I knew that large industrial companies had 40% of their earnings overseas. What does occur, however, is that the tech companies actually even have more, which I guess it would totally make sense because that's why they've stashed so much money overseas. Bottom line is that we'll see where this whole thing shakes out. But what is intriguing about that also is that it was the NDX 100 that was the hardest to get over its highs. So the NDX 100 today closed out at 49.33, and I expect what you're going to see out here tomorrow is that it's going to close under 49.11. That'll be a failure on price. We already have a failure on price and a failure on volume on the daily. That would be a failure on price and a failure on volume on the weekly. And technically it's set up, fundamentally, just looking at Oracle, it's set up. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Everything you need is right inside it, folks. Go have a blast with it. Stay right there. I'm Mr. Andy Hecht. Coming right up, folks.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.